Welcome to week 6 of Soaping 101. It is true that just about anything that can hold water can be used as a soap mold. But how do you know how to adjust your recipe for each mold? Let's take a look. This is a traditional wooden mold. This one's from Brambleberry. It holds 5 pounds of soap. And the dimensions given are 2 1/5 by 3 1/8 by 17. Know it holds 5 pounds, but what if you didn't? You could base your soap recipe on the dimensions itself. It's very simple. All we would do is times the length times the width by the diameter to get the total volume. We then take our total volume and multiply it by our multiplication factor of 0.39. This will give us 54.38 and some change, which represents the total ounces of oil that you need to make a 5-pound loaf. And if you want to double check that, you just plug that into the soap calculator and we'll come out with 79.64 ounces, which includes the oil, the lye, and the liquid. And because there's 16 ounces in a pound, we divide that by 16 and come up with 4.9775, or roughly 5 pounds of soap. Okay, now let's talk about a different kind of mold. This one is a cylindrical mold, or as you can see, a DIY homemade Pringles can. Many people like to use this to make puck-shaped soaps. The calculations for this are a little bit different. We multiply pi times the radius of the circle, square it, and then multiply that by the height of the mold. So the radius is half of the total width of the tube, or 3.1 divided by 2. Then we square that and come up with a number of 2.4025. We then take that number and we multiply it by pi. 3.14 times 2.425 times the length or the height of the mold, which is 9.2, and we get 69.4 the total volume. We then take the total volume, 69.4032, and we multiply that just as we did before by a multiplying factor of 0.39, which shows us that we will need 27.067 ounces of oil to make a loaf of soap in this mold. And because I always like to double check myself, we're going to put that back into the soap calculator. By the way, the soap calculator that I'm using is from Brambleberry, and I'll put the link below. So we find that a total yield of 39.67 ounces divided by 16, 15 ounces a pound, this will make about a 2.5-pound soap loaf. And there's one more way we're going to determine it, and this one consists of a yogurt can. Okay, here's our yogurt can. We're going to put that onto our mold, turn it on, and fill it with water. Here I filled it to just below the little lip. Looks like it holds 6.1 ounces of water. I used a yogurt cup, but you can use any vessel that'll withstand the heat of cold processed soap. We take our 6.1, multiply it by 1.8, and we get nearly 11 cubic inches. We multiply that by our multiplying factor and see that we need 4.28 ounces of oil. This will yield us a 6.16 ounce chunk of soap. Okay, let's go to the soap lab and put our theory to the test. We're going to use a Pringles can. Here I am adding the lye to the oils using 2.10 ounces of oil, 3.6 ounces of lye and 8.94 ounces of Kentucky spring water. The soap recipe that I'm using is my standard Bastille soap recipe, but you're welcome to use any oils that suit your taste. I've already added my fragrance oil to the soap, and I mixed it up with my stick blender. I'm going to separate it into four colors. They're all pink, but they're all going to be three different shades of pink. One's lighter, one's medium, and one's darker. And then the final one is a white with titanium dioxide. So we'll just mix those up, and soon you'll see the difference in the colors. The top left is the darkest shade of pink, the top right is the light pink, the bottom left is the white, and the bottom right is the medium shade. Okay, let's break out that mold. Here's the Pringles can. You can see that I have lined it with freezer paper. Not necessary, but I find it easier to get out that way. I'm going to take my first color, pour a little bit in. The second color, I'm going to pour it directly on top of it, aiming towards the center. The third. And then the fourth, the white. I'm going to continue to do this until the mold is filled up. All the while, aiming towards the center. Now that the mold is filled up, I'm going to take my wooden skewer and try to create a flower pattern from the center out to the side. And now in between, from the outside in. Now we'll throw the cap on that and let it gel overnight. Here I'm showing you what's left. Okay, 24 hours later we'll come back and see what we've got. Here's our loaf unmolded. Let's put that on the scale and see how much it weighs. If you remember before from our lesson, it should weigh 2.47 pounds. This is what was left over in the cups. Yep, 2.41 pounds. Very close. So let's cut off the ends and see what it looks like inside. Now that you know how to tailor your recipe to fit your mold, Go out there and make fun soaps. Don't limit yourself to just the square mold. Well, join us next week. We're going to be talking about the properties of oil, and we're going to be talking a little bit about super fatting. Also wanted to let you know that we have our own Facebook page. It is www.facebook.com/soaping101. So go up there, post your pictures, dazzle me. Okay, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week. Bye, y'all.